Hello everyone, I am Shongho Mitra. Tell me, how do you feel your confined life? How do you feel sitting at home, studying at home? It's too much boring, right? How much do you love your school friends, your teachers also? Do you miss? I miss badly all of you. Okay. Today, everyone can understand which text I will start. Everyone can understand, differentiate also what is real classroom and what is virtual classroom. Now, everyone you are studying at home, this is called virtual classroom through online. And when you study at classroom, sitting on the bench in the school, that is called real classroom. This story, the fun they had, today I am analyzing that. This story has been written by Isaac Asimov. So who was Isaac Asimov? He was an American biochemist and prolific science fiction writer. This story is also a science fiction based. So he was born on 2nd January 1920 and died in 1992 due to kidney and heart failure in Brooklyn of New York. This story is a science fiction based, science related. So it's a very interesting text, and the writer published about 500 books about science fictions related. He has been passed graduations in 1939 in Columbia University, and in the same university he got PhD degree in 1947. He taught biochemistry at Boston University in his career life. He became very popular for his science fiction. So now you have to know what is science fiction. Science fiction is a type of writing in which imaginary future developments in science and their effects on life are described. Science fiction writers are interested in making the world see the changes in our lives caused by the development of science. So it is regarded as a way to explore how society may change as science develops. So now you can understand what is science fiction. It's very, very interesting. I have said, now you have to know what is, how many characters are in the story. Total three characters, three main characters are there. First two characters, I am telling these names. First one is Margie Jones, who is the main protagonist, main character in this story. Margie Jones, and another protagonist is there, that's name is Tommy. And robotic teacher is there, who just explains how they can study through online. And this story goes to in future what will be that time study, so you can understand the theme of this story. In distant future, children would have lessons with mechanical teachers at home, and such a practice might deprive kids of the great fun the old school offered. Setting of the story is on 17th May 2155 in Margie and Tommy's house. The total story has been divided into four parts. Let us begin. The story centers around an old paper and ink book about school, and involves two main characters, Margie and Tommy. Text one can be divided into three parts. Part one, the background. Part two, the body of the story, a conversation between Margie and Tommy. And part three, the resolution. The story has been divided into four main parts. First one, a story of future. The story is an interesting look at the future of education and its technological dependence in times to come. Margie and Tommy are two young students who live in the 22nd century. They are taught at home by a mechanically driven computer or teaching bot. It is geared to their learning abilities and offers custom-made lesson plans. It can receive the homework and test work through a slot and analyze it within minutes. So, a robotic technique, totally. So, you can understand now it is happening. Next, a book. About a book, what they have studied into a book. Now I am describing. One day they are astonished to see a book where the words are still. Still means moveless, and the pages can be touched or traversed by flipping. He shows it to Margie, who cannot make sense of such an object. Tommy tells her that the book belonged to earlier centuries when kids studied differently. He explains that the book was about schools of the time, which does not please Margie, as she hated school, or more like hated her teaching bot. Recently, it had been giving her bad reviews in tests. When her mother got it checked, it was shown that the geography section was adjusted to an accelerated pace. The inspector repaired it and Margie got on with her lessons. Now let us begin. Schools in earlier age. What type of schools were there at that time in earlier age? He further explains about the schools of the earlier age. Human teachers and schools where everyone studied the same things together. Margie was fascinated, as her mother always told her that one has to learn independently. She wanted to know more about the school, but it was time for her day's lessons. She went to the teaching room and offered her homework. The lesson started, but Margie was stuck in a fantasy. The fun they had. That point I am analyzing. She imagined how good it must have felt to have a company of children from different places, sitting together and having conversations. Now you feel like that. She imagined how they would help each other out and have fun together. Actually, this story is a critique of the heavy dependence on technology in the modern education system, where the social and formative portion of education is being lost gradually. Now you can feel at studying at home. It's too much boring through online. Everything you have got through online, through computer, everything through net. So studying at home and at a time you got everything, notes, explanation, everything. But it's not live, not real, not alive. It's too much boring. So in this story, the writer wanted to explain, wanted to differentiate between the real classroom and virtual classroom.